Whether you just got your fancy new power station fired up only to realize it's dying a lot faster than you expected, or you're still in the research phase and nobody has warned you yet, there is one main thing that more companies need to advertise and more people need to be aware of, which can dramatically change the decision you make when it comes to which power station is actually best for you. And that is idle consumption. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're talking about idle consumption. This is something that can really fuck with your math when you're trying to decide which unit to buy or which route to go whenever you're deciding to go solar. And so here's idle consumption in simplest terms. Batteries store power in DC or direct current, but your household appliances like lights, your fridge, your fish tank, anything that's plugged into a regular 120 volt wall outlet inside of your house uses AC power or alternating current. And because of that, every power station that outputs AC and has regular house plugs on the front of it has an inverter built into it. That inverter basically just converts DC power in the batteries to AC power that you can use to power your gear. The catch here is that the inverter itself actually needs energy to stay ready for action. Think of it like leaving your car on running in the driveway in park. You're not going anywhere, but it's still out there consuming gas because at any point you could just walk out to it, get in, and drive away. And so we're gonna try and keep it simple. We don't wanna go over anybody's head, including tiny babies, which wouldn't be that hard. But basically it's unavoidable. If you think about all the technology that's inside of a power station like this, the inverter's internal components need power. The micro boards and internal processing inside of the brain needs to consume power. And there's also something called switching losses. So basically, direct current is, if you've ever seen like this graph, basically direct current is like a straight line and alternating current is like a wave form. The inverter is basically switching back and forth really quickly, making a pulse that essentially makes power go into this wave form, which is what makes it alternating current. And those components switching back and forth really quickly to create that wave form is what's consuming your power, because once this inverter is on, even if you have nothing plugged into it, there's power ready to go at these plugs at all times. And so sure, there's also other things like the screen being on consumes a little bit of power, the fans running to cool the unit down consume a little bit of power, the Wi-Fi, if you have your Wi-Fi turned on, that'll consume a little bit of power. And the annoying part about all of this is that idle consumption is not a standardized number. Every inverter, depending on how many plugs, how much power it's able to produce, is gonna consume a different amount of power, and companies don't advertise this. If you were to buy like a solar inverter for like whole home backup or off-grid power, they advertise how much power they consume when idling. Power station companies don't advertise that number though, and that's something that we think that they really need to start to do. An example of this, the very first time that we realized that, we always knew this is a thing, but the first time that it impacted us was when we made the Can You Survive a 24-Hour Blackout with the Anker F3800 video. We used that thing all day and the power losses seemed accurate. We were running things, the battery was slowly dying, but when we went to bed, all we were running was a fridge and the Wi-Fi router. And when we woke up, the thing was almost dead. And we were like blown away at how much power it consumed when we really weren't doing anything with it during the night. So much so that we actually made this a standard test in all of our review videos afterwards to make sure that we test the idle consumption of all power stations. So based on our math and our experience with that F3800, it used over 70 watts per hour just to stay running on top of whatever other loads were already going. Now, sure, it's a bigger inverter, it outputs 240 volts, so there's a lot that it's getting ready to do, a lot more than something like this small little inverter. But if you think about it, the F3800 has a 3800 watt hour battery. The fridge uses about 1300 watts per day, so it should theoretically be able to run that fridge for 2.9, pretty much 3 days. But when you add in the 70 watts per hour just evaporating into nowhere land, that within a 24-hour day actually consumes more power than the fridge itself. 70 times 24 is about 1680 watts. Just having the inverter on and the idle consumption, plus the fridge, within 24 hours, you use almost 3000 watts. And so now that power station, if you actually do the math, is only actually gonna run your fridge for like 1.25 days or something like that.
Day and a quarter.
Instead of 3 days, which is a huge difference. And they aren't always that extreme. Like I said, a smaller inverter that's doing less, has less plugs and stuff like that, will use less to idle. But at the end of the day, when they're not advertising these numbers, numbers. We don't know them unless we test them. You might buy a full setup thinking you can do one thing and you can do half if you're lucky. So what do you do about this? For starters, if you're considering buying a unit or power station that we haven't mentioned the idle consumption on, I would just message the company and ask them what the idle consumption is. We have been trying to push companies to start advertising this, but we're just two dudes. But I think that it's still a relatively new space. If a lot of people start demanding these numbers, they might end up folding and starting to publish this stuff on their websites. The second thing you can do, take advantage of the app. A lot of units come with an app, so you don't have to get up, walk over to it, and turn the inverter off. We're all notoriously lazy. If you have your app, at least you could sit down and turn the inverter on and off when you're not using it. It can also help you because a lot of them you can schedule time on and time off, so you can actually make it so that it's only running during certain hours. And the third thing that you can do is you can try to get, if you frequently have power outages, DC appliances that you can use during that time. For example, I have a DC fridge that I use when I go camping. Anker makes DC fridges for you to take to the beach or do whatever you want with. If when we went to bed we ran a DC fridge off that F3800, it wouldn't have had any idle consumption losses because all the power inside the unit is already in direct current. So if a lot of people are experiencing outages and problems like that, I would honestly right now try to recommend getting DC appliances to help make up for some of the losses. Personally, I've been able to go camping for 4 or 5 days with a small little Jackery 1000 and it's run my fridge the entire time. Whereas if you were trying to run even a tiny AC fridge, that unit would probably last 2 days if you were lucky. So anyways, hopefully this helped you guys learn something. If you guys have any other tips or tricks that you can help share to have people that already have power stations make them last longer, or maybe some DC appliances or stuff like that that people could use to help stretch the life of the power station that they're actually looking to buy, anything that you guys have, leave some down in the comments below and help some other people out. Otherwise, that's all we got for you guys. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.